Yeah, baby, yeah. Hello, hello, good morning, good afternoon, bonjour and bonsoir. Welcome to another episode of Cooking with Elia, where we take regular traditional recipes and turn them into a healthy, nutritious fare. Conscious nutrition for the fit-inspired person, baby. Yeah, baby, yeah! So today's dish will focus on classic Mexican fare called chicken fajitas. This chicken fajitas will consist of chicken breast, which will be marinated with olive oil and various spices. We'll throw in some bell peppers and onions. We'll saute them all together. We'll make our own fresh guacamole dip, our own fresh pico de gallo, and throw up some corn tortillas as well. So this dinner will once again be high in protein, high in healthy fats, while low on carbs, and absolutely gluten-free, baby, yeah! Cause you're a sexy bitch! Yeah, baby, yeah! Boom. So today I'd like to announce that I'll be, expanding my show by inviting in our guests from the fitness and sports arena, basically. They're gonna come on the show, I'm gonna ask them a few questions, like interview them just a little bit, yeah? And then they're going to help me cook whatever the dish of the day is. And I would very proudly like to announce that today's first ever guest on Cooking with Elia is a former World Bantamweight Boxing Champion, baby, yeah! By the name of Paul Banke. Paul is a native Californian, but his roots trace way back to good old Mexico. So I hope you sit back and enjoy the show.
He wanted to get some positioning, but then he ran into some chopping rights and lefts, and down he went for the final time.
The new WBC Super Bantamweight Champion of the World, the real Paul Banke.
Okay, welcome back. I'm here with the real Paul Banke, World Bantamweight Champion, baby, yeah! So he's gonna help me cook the fabulous chicken fajitas today, but before he does, I'm gonna ask him a few questions. First off, Paul, welcome to Cooking with Elia. It's an honor to have you here. How are you?
I'm honored to be here. Thank you for inviting me out.
So Paul, how does it feel to be champion of the world?
It feels awesome. I mean, to accomplish my dream, April 23rd, 1999, became world champion. What a blessing, you never imagined. It's like winning an Oscar, you know what I'm saying? To me, being world champion is great. Still world champion, what a blessing.
Yeah. So since you got out of the boxing ring, all these years later, you're giving back to the community by training little boys and girls so they stay out of trouble, no more gangs,
you know,
and stuff.
Something positive. Any sport is good for the kids these days, you know. Give them focus, going straight after something, having goals, you know what I'm saying? Because there's too much stuff out there now in society, you know.
So absolutely.
Something positive. Any sport is good. Boxing is great. I'm giving back to the kids. And I might as well, I'm 53 years old, let me give it back now, you know what I'm saying? What a blessing.
There you
so
go.
Thank God I'm world champion still, you know what I'm saying?
Yes, of course. Zaragoza was quite an opponent, wasn't he?
A tough kid, tough cookie.
Who were your heroes growing up when you got into boxing?
I had a lot of heroes. Of course, Muhammad Ali, the greatest of them all,
right.
You know what I'm saying? I watched all our Sugar and Leonard, all the athletes.
Sugar, right?
Yeah, you know what I'm saying?
Absolutely. And who do you have here?
Henry Armstrong.
Wow.
Great man. Four world title shots back then. They have four different title shots in four different weight classes.
Four different weight classes?
Yeah.
Great. That's incredible.
Incredible.
Fine. Well, Paul, thank you very much for answering all my questions. And I think we better get back to cooking with Elia. Let's go, baby. Yeah.
Let's go.
Here's Paul with his brand new, wonderful Rolling Stones apron, baby. Yeah. But let's go through all the ingredients we shall be using today to make this fabulous Mexican traditional dish. So we're gonna start with some freshly baked corn tortillas that I picked up from the bakery this morning. Moving along, we have the raw ingredients to a wonderfully made pico de gallo from scratch. We've got the limes, the onion, fresh tomatoes, cilantro, and of course the jalapenos. Right next to that we have a plate of garlic. Well, we're not gonna really use it, we're just there for effect. Useful prop, as they say. Next up on the list are the raw ingredients to a freshly made guacamole paste. As you can see here, we've got the cilantro, fresh tomatoes, a lot of avocado, some fresh limes, and another piece of onion. And we're gonna mix that with a pinch of salt and some cumin. Yes, I think that's right. Moving along, we're gonna chop up, and saute some bell peppers and some white onion. Rosemary. Well, never mind the rosemary today. And we're gonna mix all that with some freshly marinated chicken breast. And marinated with some water, olive oil, oregano, and various other spices. And finally, just for effect, just for the I don't know what, baby, we're gonna add a little bit of beans, whether they're black, kidney, or whatnot, just for more added flavor. And I think that's it. Now, Paul and I are gonna get to the action. Yeah, baby, yeah! See, all the onions and bell peppers are chopped up and they're ready to be thrown in a pan with a little olive oil to be sauteed. Next up, guacamole, baby. Yeah! So, I'm gonna start the avocado right there. Ooh. All right, like that, onto the side and scoop it out like that. Boom, shakalaka. That's all right. I'm the food expert. You're the boxing expert. It's all right, my man.
I smashed it like I do, guys.
Okay. So now we're ready to take this chicken breast and throw it in the oven. Now many people prefer to just chop up the chicken and pan saute in the pan, but I find that placing the chicken in the oven gives it more flavor, more juice. You know what I mean? So let's do that. All right. It's hot, baby, yeah. So let's leave it in the oven for about 20 minutes or so at 425 degrees Fahrenheit and take it from there. Saying the vegetables now, the bell peppers and the onions. Yeah, baby, look at that. Let's check on the chicken. How's the chicken doing? Ooh, watch out for that backdraft. And I think the chicken may be ready. All right, now I think it's time that we prepare the pico de gallo. What do you say, Paul?
Let's do it.
All right, let's do it. All right, you cut up the tomatoes, I cut up the jalapenos and the onions, and we take it from there.
Sounds good.
All right. We have the guacamole right here, nice and luscious. Our freshly chopped pico de gallo. And now, of course, we have the corn tortillas that we have to warm up carefully. But in the meantime, I smell something delicious coming from the oven. Let's check on our chicken breast and our sauteed vegetables, shall we? I'm very grateful to Paul, who was here today with me to help prepare this quite scrumptious Mexican dish. As you can see here, we have a variety of items prepared, such as the freshly cooked corn tortillas. We have a variety of beans, such as the black beans here and the kidney beans there. Moving on to our freshly sauteed bell peppers and onions. Of course, our freshly roasted and sliced chicken breast. Moving on to the pico de gallo that Paul and I chopped up for you, nice and wonderfully fresh. And of course, our freshly made guacamole dip. So I think Paul and I are ready to devour quite the scrumptious feast. What do you say, Paul?
Yeah, baby, yeah.
Yeah, baby, yeah.
Let's knock him out. Voz de la guitarra mía.
Me and Paul Banke are gonna go at it, baby. Yeah, I'm gonna kick his ass. We've come to the end of yet another successful episode of Cooking with Elia, with my super guest star today, World Bantamweight Boxing Champ, the real Paul Banke. Yeah, baby, yeah! But, truth be told, as he was kind enough to lend me his services in creating one of Mexico's most popular dishes, it takes more than eating healthy to create a wonderfully healthy and beautiful body. Well, think about it. It's a triangle, really. A three-part formula, if you will. Let's see. If you have to train.
You couldn't get it up.
Tell it gently. You have to eat rather healthily. And above all, you need your 8 hours of sound and restful sleep. Recuperation is most important. To be loved. Love is touch. Touch is love. Sorry. Love is reaching.
Reaching love. Hey, everyone. Now you can have the Gold's Gym logo drawn by me, the artist Rick Drayson, personalized and made out to you and signed by me to frame and put on your gym wall or wherever you see fit to do so. It's a piece of bodybuilding history. It will never be duplicated again. It's the largest selling icon t-shirt logo in the world, and I'm the guy that drew it, and I will draw it for you. Just go to my website, rickdrayson.com, and order there. You can pay through PayPal, and it'll be sent out right away. And be sure to watch Rick's Corner for all the videos on bodybuilding, nutrition, fitness, pro wrestling, and anything that suits your interest as far as getting physically fit and being the best you can be from the golden era of bodybuilding.
Okay, thank you for watching another episode of Cooking with Elia. We'll be back next time. In the meantime, be high, baby. Be groovy, baby. Yeah! Let the flight begin. So hold on tight. Let the flight begin. I'm a sexy bitch, baby. Yeah. Shall we shag now or shag later, baby? Oh, yeah. Oh, let's go shag now, baby. Absolutely.